Read that. All right, so today we have Gatsby Cloud 101. My name is Daniel Giordano. I run marketing or product marketing here at Gatsby, and I'm joined by our terrific sales engineer lead, Hannah Rosa Litton. She is going to help us. Hey, Hannah Rosa. She's going to help us with a live demo. I'm going to start this call with just a few slides. The first one being housekeeping. We will record this session. So if you have to bounce out early, don't worry, we're still going to get this over to you. But kind of a huge advantage and benefit of this one-on-one session is live questions. So feel free to ask live questions in the Q&A tab, and we will get to them as it pertains during the talk, but definitely we'll leave some time at the end to cover them. All right, so what we're covering today, we're going to kind of run through the benefits of Gatsby Cloud in general, and then we're going to go through an entire demo that Hannah Rosa has set up. So we'll sign in, connect our VCS of choice. Today it's going to be GitHub. We'll start off building a site and connecting it to a CMS, and then we'll look at some of the previous functionality of Gatsby Cloud, and then we'll look at workspaces and how it helps organize your sites if you are, say, from an agency or a large enterprise. So first, a quick intro to Gatsby. Gatsby is born 6 years ago. 2015 was our first commit. We have over 50 million downloads and over 50,000 GitHub stars. So it's a wildly popular open source project. And it contains a few things. The open source project contains the frameworks and plugins. It gives developers the tools and technology they need to build fast sites with built on React. And then cloud is a product that has builds, hosting, previews, and functions. So it's going to allow you to build, deploy, and preview your site faster than ever. So why Gatsby Cloud? We'll talk about this in kind of a framework of these four things today. Creation, collaboration, delivering the website, and then organization post. So Gatsby Cloud has 2,500 plugins. We have a set of integrations from CMSs that you can automatically hook in through Gatsby Cloud. It's gonna allow you to automatically connect to your VCS of choice like we talked about, and even fire up websites quickly from templates. Then with collaboration portion, each change that goes into the Git repository as a commit is going to build a preview deploy that is going to have an atomic URL. And each change on the CMS side is going to automatically deploy to a preview URL that we call, it's like a staging site. And that is also going to allow you to collaborate with users before you publish your website to production. So you'll have all sorts of ways that we'll look at today that you can work on your site in staging. Lastly, we're delivering on the edge network. So Gatsby Cloud has a global edge network powered by Fastly. It's a content delivery network with over 35 points of presence around the globe. We serve all traffic over HTTPS2. And it's a secure, scalable solution built on one of the largest CDNs in the world. And then lastly, organization of your web properties, of your clients' web properties, are done in workspaces, which we'll go over today. Those workspaces are unique, have unique billing properties. Users can be shared within them. It's kind of like its own little folder for your projects. And that's how we organize things. So now we'll kind of go into the live portion. I'll share my stop sharing my screen, and we'll look at Hannah Rosa.
Okay. Thank you, Dan. So, yeah, let me go ahead and share my screen. Just want to validate that you guys are seeing my screen. It should be a desktop that you guys are seeing where there's two panes.
Yeah, two panes.
Okay. All right. Cool. So before I show a live demo of how Gatsby Cloud works with a CMS like Contentful, I just wanted to cover things that you need to set up prior to deploying to Gatsby Cloud. So first and foremost, you know, this assumes you have a Gatsby site that you built locally and maybe have committed to a GitHub repo. So the next thing you need to do is set up Gatsby so that it can communicate with your CMS. So the CMS that we're gonna look at is Contentful. So you need to install the Gatsby source Contentful plugin, which I have highlighted here. And it's a pretty standard command, npm install the Gatsby source Contentful. And then you have to set up the credentials inside your Gatsby config. So here's an example of the setup where you set up both the delivery API credentials, which is what Gatsby Cloud uses to access the Contentful and basically render the content. And you have to also set up your preview API. This is what allows Gatsby to serve preview content before it gets published. So that's the first thing you have to do. And next, you have to install the Gatsby Cloud plugin, which is how Gatsby Cloud communicates with your VCS. So those are the first things you have to do. Next, what I want to show, I'm going to just change my screen here. What I want to show now is how you add a site. So first, of course, you have to have a Gatsby account. And typically when you set up your Gatsby account, you use like your GitHub credentials, and that's how Gatsby will authenticate you. So assuming you have a Gatsby account, the first thing you do is add a site. So here I'm in my own workspace, as Dan was talking about. So workspaces are a way to have different sites. So if I was an agency, as an example, this Contentful demo could be for one customer. This themes example could be for another customer. So that's how our workspaces can be used. So let's say I want to add a new site. Let's just click add a site. I can get it from a Git repository or a template. For this example, I'll get it from a Git repository. I'm going to use GitHub. I just select the organization that I want to get the file from. So I have my own organization called Glidden. I'm going to look for a Gatsby site. I'm going to choose this one. And the base branch is exactly where the root or where your files live. Maybe you have it in another branch, maybe it's not the main. Basically, you just tell Gatsby where to get your code from. And then the base directory is typically the root. And the root, or what the base directory is doing, is it's looking for Gatsby config, because that's where Gatsby Cloud will understand what to load and what credentials are needed. So I'm going to keep it at the root because that's where my Gatsby config is. And then your site name is, it defaults to the name of your GitHub repo, and it will add name. I just want to call it recipes Gatsby. And then I hit next. And your site, then Gatsby asks, do you want to connect to the CMSs? Because I set up Contentful in my Gatsby config, I don't need to do this step, but if you're using a template, for example, you would need to do this step. So I'm just going to show you what it would look like. So you basically authorize Gatsby to connect to Contentful, and then Gatsby will look at your Contentful and look at the different spaces in Contentful. So there's a Gatsby space that I have, and then I could just point it to a different space. I'm going to cancel that out because I don't need to do that step, but I just wanted to show you what you would expect. And then you would, the next step is to, add your environment variables and then create the site. So that's quickly how you would create a site from scratch. So just checking, are there questions there before I move on? I don't think there are. All right, so, okay. Next, what I wanna do is go through how you interact with a CMS like Contentful. What I'm gonna show you is first how content is added and how you can preview that and share it with your team. And then I'm going to show, you know, how you publish it and talk about like how, show you in real, you know, live, how fast Gatsby builds and deploys the site. So I have a site here called Gatsby Contentful Demo. It's connected to my Contentful space here to the right. So I'm going to just move my screen here. I'm just going to show you what this site looks like. I'm going to just copy this link. Copy link address. I'm going to open it in this tab here. So basically, this is what the site looks like. There is a piece of content that I'm working on here, this recipe with Kawatabi, and you can see there's no content here. So we need to change that and add content. So here on the right-hand side, I'm at my Contentful space. I'm gonna actually go to the Kawatabi area. I'm gonna make this a little bigger so you can see. You can see there's nothing here. So what I want to do is actually put in the right content. I'm going to just copy and paste the content that I want. So as I'm adding that, basically you see that Gatsby says saving. Now I can look at a preview. So let me actually open a preview. And you, one of the things you notice is the preview link has the word preview in there. So you know that you are in a preview state, like a staging site. And you can see that Gatsby now is saying it's building a new preview. So that's, while that's running, I will, let's see, share. I want to point out that, yeah, the preview is done. So if I click to view, I go to my Kawatabi, I see that the content is there that I just added in preview. It's not published. Like if I refresh the site stuff on the left, it still has the old content because this is preview. So typically what the workflow would be is you would grab this link here and, you know, share it with your team and say, hey, look, does this content look good? Everyone reviews. Okay, you say, okay, everything looks good. Let's actually publish these changes. So now it's published. Let's take a look at Gatsby Cloud. Let me just move my screen here. Because what will happen is Gatsby is going to tell me that data is being updated from Contentful. So it's saying that. Looks like it got published and built in 4 seconds, deployed in 8. So let's check out the new site. I'm going to refresh it. There you go. So that's the new content. So what I just shared is a typical workflow. You preview something, share it with your team, publish. And as you can see, that happened very quickly. And you know, that 4 second build deployed in 8. So that's again, the advantage of Gatsby Cloud. Things are very fast. The other thing I wanted to share is that perhaps you have other teams working on other features. So as you can see down here, I have a pull request where I have another developer waiting, you know, wanting to add a blog page. So this is another capability in Gatsby Cloud where you have other people working on features and they can create a pull request and you can review it and see what it looks like. If things look good, then you can merge. So Gatsby Cloud is a very collaborative platform and really is very user-friendly, very performant, and encourage you to keep trying it out. Well, that's all I have for now, Dan, and so back to you.
All right. It doesn't look like we have any questions right now. Thank you, though, for going through that. We'll give it like 2 more minutes for any live questions. And then if not, we'll close out and we will be back after Gatsby Camp, which I guess we can plug right now. Gatsby Camp, you can head over to the URL. Let me get it for you right now. It's on the homepage. All right, I will drop this in the chat. This will be our closing argument today. Feel free to join us, Gatsby Camp. It is on Thursday, September 16th. We have some awesome speakers. It's a one-day event. Awesome, thank you, Aaron. It's a one-day event where we will be going over tons of user stories. You'll hear from live actual Gatsby customers that have used Gatsby to scale to millions of site visitors and hundreds of developers working on projects. So it'll be an awesome day. We've been running these. This will be our second one. So feel free to join us. Everything's free, you just need to register. All right, sweet. And we have two questions as well, so we'll get to that. All right, first one, does Gatsby Cloud support a database? Gatsby Cloud actually works with serverless functions underlying. So we have a serverless functions functionality where you can incur a request to nearly any database. We have examples with Supabase, with MongoDB. I will share those here, but everything can work through our functions functionality. Anything to add there, Henrosa?
Yeah, I was just going to say that I have a link here that I can share where if you wanted to source from a database, definitely is something we can do. So let me share that link online.
Okay, awesome. Okay. And then, so in-app notifications, if I'm reading that right, I think that, again, it's kind of on the framework side and can easily work with functions as well. So you can apply maybe like a chatbot or a notification bar in your app and kind of fire it off via the function. I think we have an example of actually that as well.
Yeah. And also I want to add, you could actually set up a notification for your builds for your builds, previews coming. I actually have a setup and I wanted to share this on screen, but I did have a setup where I have my Slack notify me when a build is complete. So you can use that. You can have a notification because we do have a webhook for notifications. So yes.
Okay, that's awesome. And then lastly, the Azure DevOps. Can I link Gatsby Cloud with VCS from Azure DevOps instead of GitHub? Currently you can't, but we do have a couple of successful customers mirroring their Azure DevOps repo into a GitHub repo. If you use VCS code, it's just a plug-in away. It's actually really easy to do, but that is what we recommend today, is mirroring that entire repo into a GitHub repo and then taking it from that.
Yep.
Anything to add there, Henrosa? I think, right, that is the way we recommend today.
Yes, that is correct.
Perfect. And we do have customers who are successful with it, so we do know it works. And actually, I have the piece up right now. Hang on 1 minute, I can share that. Right here. Here is the link for that plugin. Awesome. All right. Any other questions? Wondering if it is possible to use Drupal as CMS. Definitely is. Yes. We have Drupal is we call them source plugins, so content source plugins. It's part of our plugin architecture. We have one for Drupal. So we have many successful customers that use Drupal in a decoupled or headless manner, use that as their backend and build on Gatsby Cloud. All right. Thank you so much, Henrosa, for coming out and helping us with that demo. And thank you to all of the participants today, especially Nicholas and Luke. Thank you. And enjoy your go with Gatsby Cloud. If you have any other questions, feel free to contact us on support or Twitter. So gatsbyjs.com/support or check us on at gatsbyjs. Have a good one, everyone.
Thank you.